सोपानम त्री अमल नाम ते स्मरण तो मम हरसि हृच्छयम् क्लेश संचयम्। परशुराम क्षेत्र, परशुराम क्षेत्र इन द सदर्न कॉर्नर ऑफ भारत इज नोन एज केरला टुडे। श्रीमद् भागवता मेंशन्स दैट बलराम स्वामी हैड विजिटेड केरला ड्यूरिंग अ पिलग्रिमेज एंड हैड हैड दर्शन ऑफ द होली प्लेसेस एंड टेंपल्स देयर। इन एंशियंट तमिल टेक्स्ट्स केरला इज रेफर्ड टू एज मलनाडु, द लैंड ऑफ हिल्स। पेरिय पुराणम डिस्क्राइब्स श्री सुंदरमूर्ति स्वामी, द रिनाउंड डिवोटी ऑफ शिवा, एज गोइंग टू मलनाडु व्हाइल रिलेटिंग हिज विजिट टू तिरुवंजिकुलम कोडुंगल्लूर इन केरला। The land mass from Kanyakumari to Gokarna, peering out into the seas and fortified by the mountain ranges, is said to have been retrieved from the sea by Sri Parashurama. Here, at one end, Divine Mother Kanyakumari, with a marital garland in her hand, is doing tapas to attain her Lord, while Gokarneshwara Mahadeva, the embodiment of compassion, is deep in meditation at the other end. As the poet says, Paraspara tapasampat phalayita parasparau, each being the fruit of the penance of the other, this land is always protected by the beneficent glances of the divine couple. Kerala is lush green, made fertile by the flowing waters of a number of rivers like Bharatapura, Periyar and Pampa. The thick forests are full of rare varieties of medicinal trees and herbs. Naturally, this land has become an ideal place for the study and research of Ayurveda and other related sciences. Sri Rudram in the Vedas worship Lord Shiva with the word
Namo Hiranyabahave Senanye Disham Chapataye Namo Namo Vrikshebhyo Harikeshebhyah Pashunam Pataye Namo Namassaspinjarayat Vishimate Pathinam Pataye Namo Namo
Namo Vrikshebhyo Harikeshebhyah. Harikesha is one who has green hair. This portion of the earth covered with trees looks radiant as a form of Shiva himself. The long ranges of the Sahyadri and the streams leisurely winding down from them pronounce the magnificence of this Parashurama Kshetra. The sacred river Kaveri originates from Talakaveri in Kottakachala in the northern part of the state. Puranas have mentioned that the holy waters of the rivers of South India like Kaveri, Payaswini and Tamraparani, as well as Nila, Purna and Pampa, flowing westward, have the power to inspire spiritual awareness, and that large numbers of bhaktas, jnanis and avatara purushas would be born on their banks. History confirms that many mahatmas have taken birth near these rivers. Socio-religious traditions followed in Parashurama Kshetra for the past few centuries seem to be different from those of the Panchadravidas, Dravida, Karnataka, Andhra, Maharashtra, Gurjara. Even the articulation of the Veda mantras follows a different style. Although Shastras like Veda, Tantra and Ayurveda have developed significantly here, the nature of the people of this region reveals that they did not have much contact with the neighboring lands. The Brahmins of Kerala are called Nambuthiris. This name does not occur in any of the ancient texts. In ancient Tamil texts, the devotees of Lord Vishnu, the Alvars, as well as the devotees of Lord Shiva, the Nayanmas, are both called Nambi. The devotees address the Lord also as Nambi. The term literally means to have faith or to love. There is a view that the term Nambuthiri is a coined word originating from Nambi Adari, which means have faith and respect. and is therefore a synonym for Brahmana, those who are pure. Even now, names like Nambi, Nambisan and Nambiadri are in use to indicate similar sects in Kerala. Anyway, this group of Brahmins was highly cultured and has preserved many branches of mantras and shastras. It is believed that these Nambutri Brahmins were brought to Kerala by Parashurama. Researchers are still debating whether their place of origin is Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Andhra, Kashmir, Maharashtra or Bengal. But no one is able to reach any decisive conclusion in such matters. Therefore, let us focus on our topic. In the heart of Kerala, there was a small village on the banks of River Periyar near the Shiva Kshetra called Aluva, which got its name from a Tamil name of Shiva, Alavayan, meaning one who has consumed poison. Here Periyar is known as Purna Nadi, as the river became fulfilled and sacred, Purna, by the touch of the divine feet of the Lord. Hence the village is known as Kaladi. Kaladi means divine feet. Many Brahmins lived in this village. They devoutly studied the Vedas, performed Agnihotras, worshipped the Lord, upheld Dharma, and remained dispassionate towards worldly affairs. Among them was a Yadhika Brahmana, a Brahmin who performed sacrifices, called Vidyadhiraja, who was revered as Kulapati or Mahashala. These reverential terms designate the one who guides and supervises several yajñas and is the chief acharya of various Veda Patashalas. Shivaguru was his only son. The name Shivaguru means Shiva's guru or Shiva's father. Shivaguru. Shivaguru spent his Gurukula days with a great Vedic scholar who was his father's friend. The young Brahmachari was of a serious disposition and was devoted to his studies and tapas. He learnt the Vedas, served the Guru in his Agnihotra Shala, and remained indifferent towards worldly affairs. He had absolutely no interest in Grihasthashrama, so he continued as a Brahmachari in the Gurukula for more than a decade. His only companions were his own spiritual practices, including Gayatri Japa, Brahma Yajna, and the fire that he preserved with samit, sacred fire twigs. He also assisted his guru in maintaining the three Agnis, fires, Ahavaniya, Garhapatya and Dakshina. As days passed by, his aging parents grew weak and fell ill. A messenger was sent to the Patashala to fetch Shivaguru home. Shivaguru's teacher also had felt that it was high time for him to complete his studies and return home. When Shivaguru came to know about this, one day the dispassionate Brahmachari left the Patashala without informing anyone and walked away. Ascertaining that wealth, wife, cattle and home are all dreadful and perishable bondages. Rayah kalatram pashavo grihadayah sarve kshaishnavah. Shivaguru walked swiftly deep in contemplation and reached a place far away from the Patashala. Overcome by hunger and thirst, he refreshed himself by drinking cool water from a stream and rested for a while under the shade of a peepal tree. Soon he dozed off. He dreamt that he was walking through a forest and saw a river, a hermitage and many rishis performing tapas there. He asked one of them, "Whose ashram is this, full of peepal trees?" In reply, a young ascetic pointed to sage Agastya and said, "There he is, the great sage who abides on the pinnacle of tapas." The sage looked like the short-statured Vamana, but was like the colossal Trivikrama in his jnana. As Lord Vishnu pervaded all the three worlds with his feet, this sage also transcended all the three states, avasthatrayam, with his knowledge. With overwhelming devotion, Shivaguru prostrated at the feet of the great sage Agastya. The compassionate sage placed his hands on Shivaguru's head and blessed him, saying, Shiva, samavartanam kuru, manovrittanu sarinim patnim labhasva, sakshat parameshwarah te grihe avibhavishyati. Shiva, go home after samavartanam. Accept the wife who suits you. Lord Parameshwara himself will manifest in your house. At this moment, Shivaguru woke up. The experience was so clear and distinct that he did not dismiss it as a dream. He performed Madhyanika, the prescribed ritual for the midday, in the river and walked back towards the Patashala. Thus ends the third Sopanam.